Hi and welcome back to the MyGrow YouTube channel. My name is Shane, I'm the founder of MyGrow. And today we're going to look at the testing equipment that I use to measure the useful light output of a grow light or grow lighting system. And there are two measurements I take. One is PPFD, or the amount of light, power light, hitting at a point in the test area. And for that I use the Apogee SQ500 quantum sensor. We'll talk a little bit about that and the pluses and minuses of using this one versus others. And then when I'm looking at the spectrum output of a grow light, I use the Sensitech Passport with the S-Gal application. So this is a sensor that you can look at the spectral output of a light source and see what the color temperature is, how much red, blue, and green is in it, and CRI if you wish to, and all that sort of stuff. So we'll look at that in detail too. So let's get started. First one, the Apogee SQ500. This is, as I said, called a quantum sensor. And when I'm doing testing of grow lights, I will set up a grow light. Here you have the MyGrow 100 over a test area. Usually we'll have reflective walls around it, and I will take measurements across a grid, and in each part of the grid I will record that measurement, and by averaging out the measurement across this test area, it enables me to calculate the total amount of light being output by the system. This quantum sensor is very accurate. It's, as I said, it's by Apogee, an American company. It's called the SQ500, or the 500 series. In this case, it's not powered itself. When the photons of light impact on the sensor, the sensor actually outputs a small voltage in millivolts. And so I use a little display device here, which is just has a good visual display for the camera. And this visual display reads out in 10 millivolts a piece. So here we have 10 power units. So here we have a 2.4 readout. That's actually 2.4 millivolts, which translates into 240 power. And as you can see, when I turn up and down the dimmer on the light, the response of this is pretty much immediate. So it's great when you're taking lots of readings, because you can move it, take a reading pretty much immediately, move it, take a reading pretty much immediately, and it's very stable. You get a slight bit of flickering when it's in between two points on the measurement scale, but generally I found it very stable and very good. The other benefits of this is its accuracy. So I'll put the graph up on screen, but you can see that the measurement, the critical area of measurement, or range of measurement for this, is to measure light between 400 and 700 nanometers in wavelength, and that's from blue to red on the spectrum. That is the light which is, that is power light, or what we define as power light, photosynthetically active radiation, is measuring the amount of light emitted by a light source in that range from 400 to 700 nanometers. And the sensor in this instance picks up pretty accurately the full range of light wavelengths. It's able to record them all pretty much evenly and accurately. So on their own website, Apogee, they demonstrate that for in the worst case scenario, the reading may be out by as much as 3.5%, I think it is. So that's, for any light source, that's the highest level of inaccuracy it can have, but that's pretty accurate in my book. And once you're using the same sensor amongst different grow light sources, you're going to get consistency anyway in the measurement. So I find it very, very quick, very accurate, very useful. I put on this little mounting plate just so I can center it onto the grids when I'm taking the measurements. And the other big feature about this, and a very important feature, it's called cosine correction. And you may be able to see on the top of the sensor, it has sort of a dome shaped, it's dome shaped on the top. And the collection cover here, this white frosted cover, actually enables the sensor to read light coming in from all directions, and it does that very accurately. In fact, this is the big difference between, there's two differences between this and the much cheaper one that's on the market, which is the Hydrofarm. And the Hydrofarm has two issues, it seems. It does not read blue as accurately compared to other lights, other sensors, quantum sensors. But the most critical factor is that its cosine correction, or its ability to take accurate readings when light is coming from multiple directions, is limited. So the Hydrofarm is inaccurate in that circumstance. And there's a very good link, or a link to a very good video. It's Ryan's channel called Growing Answers. I put a link in the description below. But he does an excellent video comparing the SQ500 and the Hydrofarm in different circumstances. And generally, when it's taking a direct reading from above, they are within about 10% for different types of light spectrum. So we test them with HPS, metal halide, sunlight, blurple LEDs, all sorts of stuff. Does a great job on it. And demonstrates that the Hydrofarm is reasonably accurate within about 10% on most light sources to the SQ500. But the biggest variance is when he's taking actually of the sunlight measurement from an angle, and you can see that it drifts quite significantly. I've also put a link to the Apogee document, which shows the difference between those two devices. So the Hydrofarm is okay for a point measurement from a single light source. But when you get to light that's getting bounced around, so HPS in a reflective tent, for example, light is coming at the sensor from all directions, and the Hydrofarm will not pick that up accurately, whereas the Apogee SQ500 will. So it's an excellent sensor, really easy to use, relatively cheap. It's about €350. Just for the sensor, and you can plug it in even to an electric millivolt meter if you have one, regular meter. But yeah, I love it, use it all the time, and find it excellent. So the next thing I use is the Sensatec Passport, and this is the spectroradiometer. And this is, first we'll start off with the point that I don't use this for measuring PPFD and system measurements, because you may be able to see on the top there the collection where the light enters it is recessed into the frame, and that means when light is coming at an angle, it's not picking that up accurately. So it doesn't have the same cosine correction, and is not good for taking measurements, particularly in a grow tent, for example, where you're getting light coming at it from all directions. So it'll get a point measurement when you're just reading a direct down high intensity light. It's pretty accurate, and in fact, I've compared the SQ500 and the Sensatec as best I can with a single direction light source, and it's very accurate. It's within a few percent, sort of 5%, up to about 1,000 power, and they start to drift apart. I'll show a chart at the end of the video which will have that information on it. It's in the comparison between the two. So really I use this not for taking PPFD measurements, but for assessing the spectrum. And I'll show you how I do that now. So switch the guy on, open up the sensor, switch the guy on under the light source. It's probably a bit intense. Let's dim it down a bit. And then I open up the application that you get with it, which you can download and play around with, by the way. It's free. It's called Sgal App, S-G-A-L. So I'll just turn my screen recorder on here so you can see what I'm doing. I find the app, I will open it up. Found it. Okay. So you connect. It's connected, but connects by Bluetooth. I just pair it up. Once it's connected, then I just go for a single measurement. Take a measurement. And you can see there the spectrum. It's showing the McCree curve there in white as the reference point. And you can see then the micro 3.5K color temperature full spectrum light output there. So it shows you the original spectrum. There's PPFD spectrum, weighted spectrum, which is, I'm not going to go into it here, but it's another way of measuring the PPFD output, the spectral output. And then you get into the really good stuff. So first is a PPFD measurement. So you can see it's 477 right there under the light. And I will try and replicate the height and position of that with this sensor. It should be about there. And we are getting, 550. So it's within about 10% there.
Same height?
Yeah, it's the same height there, I think. 530, 540. So it shows you that it's, that this one obviously is going to be taking in light from different directions, so it should be reading a slightly higher figure. I've got lots of other lights around here which are going to be inputting into it. In fact, I can demonstrate that just by turning this off. So you can see, it's getting a reading of 30 just from the ambient around. So 30 added. Anyway, they're close. And the measurements are there at the end. Other things you can tell, so you can see the, let me go back. You can see the quantity of far red. Now that reads up to 780. You can see the quantity separated out of red, green, and blue. So you can work out the proportions of red, green, and blue in different light sources. It does read down to 380 nanometers, which is a little bit down into the UVA. Not the critical bit for growing, but it gives you an indication if there's some there. And then gives you some other useful information. So the ratio of red to blue, how much daily light integral at 12 hours a day that would result in. Illuminance level, so that's equal to 35,000 lux. Color temperature, CRI. It's an excellent app. I then can compare. So, for example, I can look at comparisons between different lights that I've looked at. So, let's see, let's look at the Viper V300 versus the Micro 100. So there you can see the V300 in purple, sorry, in orange. It's a blurple light, and compare it to the Micro. So you can compare spectrum. So yeah, that's it really. That's the methodology and the kit that I use. Some of the things that I use a thermal sensor sometimes to look at heat, and use a good meter, and I use a power meter, which just detecting the consumed power from grow lights, just a regular wall plug meter. That's about it. So, hope this helps. Any questions, please let me know, and take care. Bye.